example. I have just one more. This has to do with the Ford Pinto. I'm not sure if you're aware of the recent revelations that have come out about the production of that car. Ford produced it knowing full well that in any rear-end collision, the gas tank would blow up because they had failed to install a $13 plastic block in front of the gas tank. And Ford estimated in an internal memo that that would cost about 200 lives a year. And they estimated further that the cost of each life would be $200,000. They multiplied and they found that the cost of installing those blocks in each of the cars would be more than the cost of saving those 200 lives. And over the past 7 years, the car has been produced and over 1,000 lives have been lost. It seems to me that Ford did what would be the right thing according to your policy. And yet that seems to me to be very wrong.
Well, let me ask you, let's suppose it would have cost $1 billion per person. Should Ford have put them in nonetheless?
You're really only arguing about price.
You're not arguing about principle. Nobody can take the principle. Nobody can accept the principle that that an infinite value should be put on an individual life. Because in order to get the money involved, in order to get the resources involved, it's not money. In order to get the resources, they have to come from somewhere. And you want the policy which is maximizes the situation overall. You cannot accept a situation that 1 million people should starve in order to provide one person with a car that is completely safe.
That's absolutely right.
Right. And therefore, you're not arguing anything about principle. You're just arguing whether Ford used $200,000 was the right number or not.
No, I'm not arguing that.
Suppose it were
$200
million.
No.
Suppose it were $200 million, what should Ford have done?
$200 million for what?
Suppose it would have cost $200 million per life saved. Should Ford still have spent that $200 million?
You mean per...
That's not the question.
That's not really the question.
Yes, it is a question.
Yes,
that's the principle of the question. That's the only principle involved. I don't know whether Ford did came to the right answer or not. That's a question of whether these numbers are valid numbers for the relative costs of different things. You're not arguing about a principle. If you once agree with me that if it had been $200 million, the cost per life save had been $200 million, you would not argue. Look, let me go back for a moment.
Can I say something in response to that? If Ford had not been able to market those cars in the same kind of economic bracket because of the price of installing this one plastic block, that would be a different question. Maybe Ford could have considered redesigning the whole car so as to make it cheaper. But what we're talking about is balancing advantages and balancing principles.
Of course, and that's why you're...
Just a minute.
You're only talking
I'm a supporter of abortion. Therefore, I don't believe that every single human life is sacred. I believe that principles have to be balanced. And yet, I don't see Ford spending $13 less on each car at the cost of 200 lives a year as being a principled position to take,
One fewer life a year. So that the $13 per car, so that that one life, instead of being 200 times, what's 200 times 200,000, and it's 40 million. Suppose it had been one life a year, so that it had cost 40 million. Would it then have been okay for Ford not
to
afford
it? You can't predict that one life is going to be cost because of a physical defect in the car. This was a clear...
I know, but this is, you're evading the question of principle.
No, I'm not. I'm saying that they knew before they put the car out that there was a mechanical defect.
You know when you buy a car, you know that your chance of being killed in a Pinto is greater than your chance of being killed in a Mack truck.
No, I didn't. I didn't know that the gas tank would rupture.
Of course it is a question. Well, every one of us separately in this room could, at a cost, reduce his risk of dying tomorrow. You don't have to walk across the street. Of course. The question is he willing to pay for it? And the question here he should be raising, if he wants to raise a question of principle, the principle he should raise is whether Ford wasn't required to attach to this car the statement, we have made this car $13 cheaper, and therefore it is one, whatever the percent is, it is 1% more risky for you to buy it.
But why?
Then he would be arguing a real question of principle.
Why should they do that? Doesn't that interfere with the free enterprise system that you're touting? Why not?
Because the consumer should be free to decide what risk he wants to bear. If you want to pay $13 extra for that, you should be free to do it. If you don't want to pay $13...
Wait.
Excuse me, we have to keep it to the audio over here.
So then the government does have the right to require information of corporations,
No.
Is that right?
No, the government has a right to provide courts of law in which corporations that deliberately conceal material that is relevant can be sued for fraud and made to pay very heavy expenses. And that is a desirable part of the market, of course. What I'm trying to say to you is that these things are really a little bit more subtle and sophisticated than you are at first led to believe. There are no, you can't get easy answers along this line, because your way of putting it really only doesn't really get at the fundamental principles involved. The real fundamental principle is that people individually should be free to decide how much they're willing to pay for reducing the chances of their death. Now, people mostly aren't willing to pay very much. I personally regard this as very, very illogical. I see people on all sides of me smoking. Now, there's no doubt, nobody denies that that increases their chance of death. I'm not saying they shouldn't be free to smoke, don't misunderstand me. I just think they're fools to do it. And I know they're fools, because I quit on the basis of the evidence 18 years ago. But that's the real issue. And if you want to berate Ford, you ought to be rated on those terms, not on the ground that you don't think they use the right numbers. Now, look, I don't think we can keep on going very much. I'm afraid we're going to run out of tape, and I'm afraid I'm going to run out of voice. So I think I'll call it there. Thank you.